Waller Rink on the campus of Merrimack College here in North Andover, Massachusetts, the site of tonight's Hockey East matchup, a rematch of a good one last night as the Providence College Friars pay visit to the Merrimack College Warriors.
Colquist resets. Tavernier up for Colquist. Walks it along the blue line, plays it left wing, Cini. Cini back across. Tavernier steps into it. Score! A long wrist shot for Sammy Tavernier and a power play goal puts Merrimack on the board early.
Well, Tavernier has that ability to shoot a puck, has the ability to finish plays.
Stayed very poised, stayed balanced, stayed big and square. He didn't give him much to shoot at.
Jace Henning sets one up. Carl scores! Alex Carl kind of double clutched on the shot, but when he took it, he beats Hockey and it's 2-0 Merrimack. In this first period, puck comes bouncing deep into the Warrior zone. Dockery reversed it for Carl, but it was out of his reach. Puck in front, Pantano can't make the save. They score, and it's Vimal Sukumaran who was able to tip that in as the Warriors just got a little loose in their own zone.
Watch your guys missing that 2 shot.
Colquist will bring behind his net here. Davis kept alive and fired wide. This is Jacob Bryson sending one into the middle. Picked off and moved out. Ludvig Larsson got the pass from Henning. Larsson stepping right in, across, score! Jace Henning on a terrific back and forth. Goes careening into the wall. The Warriors have a 3-1 lead. Larsson tipped it on toward Hockey. Strays out to play it. Rips it around the glass far side. Kept alive and shot back deep by McBride. Larsson cuts it back toward the far corner. He had designs on getting that right out in front. He shoots and he scores. Ludvig Larsson up over the glove side again. It is 4-1 Merrimack.
He earned that one. He went and got the puck. He created the posture for himself to have a good shooting angle.
Cini to Colquist. Takes a look around. Final 10 seconds of the period. Cini shot blocked by Baum on one knee. Now it's Henning to keep alive. Colquist with a shot. Score! Colquist with a 60-footer that deflected off of the diving Hennessy, it looked like, and found the back of the net with 1.2 left in the first. It is 5-1 Merrimack. Off for Wilkins. Wilkins works it down the wall. Pino in the corner. Back to Wilkins. Takes a look around. Deals over for Foley. Shot scores. Foley wanted that spot. He's been camped over there and they finally got it to him, and the power play goal gets the Friars back within three. 3-on-3, they battle for it in the corner. A lot of empty space around the rest of the offensive zone. Bryson, they work in front, and they score, and it's Foley on the rebound. Just off to the side of Pantano, another power play goal, and it's gone from 5-1 to 5-3 very quickly. Over to Young, back to Mirages, takes the long shot, blocked off his teammate, Sukumaran. Brought behind the net by Young, Stuffer scores! Spencer Young caught Pantano by surprise as that puck finds its way into the net and it's 5-4. Carries it all the way out to the blue line, hands off there to Colquist. Over for Tavernier. Steps in, now gives back up top for Colquist. Puck was rolling on him, got the shot, rebound, score! Ludvig Larsson with his back to the net, able to knock in the rebound, and the Warriors with a power play goal extended to a 2-goal lead. Friars win it, up off glass and out. Duhame giving chase right on the back of Biega. Puck won by the Friars, sent out for Bryson, he scores! And just like that, Providence is back within one on the goal by Jacob Bryson.
I would suspect he's a good student.
Has a chance right in front, score!
There's your
Shane
face.
Cavanaugh right off the faceoff, drove to the front of the net, tucks it behind Pantano, and it's 6-6.
There's your faceoff goal. And again, they run very effective players. He came right off the wing, I believe. Just walked in on a loose puck, unimpeded.
Second of the year.
Kind of a broken play. Picked up the puck, jumped over, and
and run the clock. Young centered, broken up by Titcomb, and that'll bring us to the buzzer. And this one's going to go to overtime, tied at six.
Who would have thunk at the end of the first period? It would turn out to be a 6-6 game. Looks like so one-sided.
Tate stopped by Titcomb. Free puck near the red line. Providence will come back into their own zone with Davis sending for Young and Wilkins. One last chance here with 2 seconds. Moving in, Pantano the save as time expires. And this one will finish in a 6-6 tie.